Hi folks, welcome to Cancer Healing Vlogs. Although the topic here is cancer healing vlogs, I feel it's a little bit imperative to focus more on the current need of the hour, which is the coronavirus situation. So I was thinking maybe a few videos on that subject, focusing more on the pathological aspect of it, more on the understanding of a disease like that in general would be of value. So I did a bit of research on the subject of, well, not much of research, but just a basic understanding that might be of some value to you, is that how does a respiratory droplet travel? So when a person coughs, what's happening is that there are particles of small droplets which the eyes cannot see travel along with that cough. Even in a sneeze, in fact, even while normal breathing, there are small droplets which are in microns, probably 2 to 5 microns. And the thing is that sometimes these droplets are a little bit bigger also, like maybe 30 to 40 microns, depending on whether it's a cough, whether it's a sneeze. And at the same time, the type of the way in which it's released decides its speed as well, its speed of its projectile. And that shows how far it will go. But there are some other factors that play a role in how far that droplet, those thousands of droplets, and if you're looking at one droplet at a time, how far that one droplet will travel. One of the factors is the size being an important thing, because what happens is that when the projectile is being released, it's getting evaporated slowly, slowly as it's moving forward until it gets completely evaporated, and then it's no longer a droplet. The larger it is, the more time it will take to evaporate, obviously. So the size is an important here, but then also the speed of the projectile. Along with the projectile, so sneezing will push it much farther ahead, right? Obviously. But even if you look at simply like the ventilation around, so there is a ventilation system that's allowing the projectile to move forward faster. That will make the droplet move longer distances. You know, vents, air ducts, these factors play a role. Even just the basic ventilation system can help it move forward. So these factors play a role. Obviously, now I'm not going to the high level physics of it, but you know, there are these guidelines which say keep a distance of 1 meter, but sometimes it can travel to 3 to 4 meters. So you just have to do your best and keep your social distancing when it comes to droplets, and of course the mask helps a lot as well. And the way these droplets travel will decide how far and what are the chances of that droplet reaching a person who is in close contact, and how long they will stay suspended in the air and a person can inhale them. So this is just the droplet aspect of it. Of course, we have not considered the part that it is in, the droplet is touching some place and then a person comes and touches that and then it spreads further ahead. We've just discussed the aspect of a droplet, how far it can spread. Hope this gives you some further insight into what you may want to learn more about this subject. Cheers, take care.